When we talk about success rates in fertility treatments, we need to make sure that we know exactly what we are talking about. Patients would use success rates to compare fertility treatments and also to compare fertility clinics before making a decision on which would be the best treatment or the best clinic to undergo the fertility treatment. So, of course, the goal of any fertility treatment is having a healthy baby at home. So the most important success rate would be the healthy baby at home, or the newborn rate, which is the goal of any fertility treatment. But of course, from a medical point of view, we will use other success rates to compare the results of different fertility treatments. So we have a pregnancy rate, which is having a positive pregnancy test. We also do have evaluative pregnancy rates, which means having a pregnancy that will finally give us a normal pregnancy and would exclude, of course, ectopic pregnancies and miscarriage. So when we're looking to success rates per treatment, we need to make sure if we are talking about baby at home, evaluative pregnancy, or having a positive pregnancy test. Also, when we talk about success rates, we need to make sure if we are talking about success rates per transfer, or if we're talking about success rates per started treatments. During treatment, we might need to cancel the cycle for different reasons, because there is no follicle growing under ovarian stimulation, because we don't have oocytes after the pickup, or we don't have mature oocytes, or sometimes because fecundation will fail and we won't have embryos. And even when we have day 5 embryos, sometimes the cycle has to be cancelled because they are not high quality blastocysts, or because they have been studied and they are abnormal from a chromosomal point of view. So it's very important to make sure, if we're talking about success rates per transfer, so a patient that finally had a high quality blastocyst to transfer, or success rates every time that we start a treatment. And finally, we need to explain the difference between pregnancy rate per transfer and cumulative pregnancy rate. Pregnancy rate per transfer is the chance of having a positive pregnancy test after a single transfer, and cumulative pregnancy rates refers to the results after all the embryos that we had from one ovarian stimulation. That might include a fresh embryo transfer and sometimes other thawed embryo transfer from the same ovarian stimulation. So if after a high quality day 5 transfer, we might have a pregnancy rate up to 65%, if we have a frozen embryo to transfer, this cumulative pregnancy rate might raise up to 85-86%, and if we still have a third embryo to transfer, this pregnancy rates might be over 90%. So when we're comparing results, we need to make sure that we know if we're talking about pregnancy rates per transfer or the cumulative rates for a whole cycle of fertility treatment.